Hi friends, my name is Nandita. I am from Andhra Pradesh. Hi friends, my name is Nandita. I am from Andhra Pradesh.
Good morning dear students. Today we are going to discuss about Structural Organization in Animals, Chapter 7 from CBSE Syllabus, Class Plus 1. Children, in the preceding chapters, you come across a large variety of organisms, both unicellular and multicellular, of the animal kingdom. In unicellular organisms, all functions like digestion, respiration, and reproduction are performed by a single cell. In the complex body of multicellular animals, the same basic functions are carried out by different groups of cells in well-organized manner. The body of simple organisms like Hydra is made up of different types of cells, and the number of cells in each type can be in thousands. The human body is composed of billions of cells to perform various functions. How to do these cells in the body work together? In multicellular animals, a group of similar cells along with intercellular substance perform a specific function. Such an organization is called tissue. Children, you may be surprised to know that all complex animals consist of only four basic types of tissues. These tissues are organized in a specific proportion and patterns to form an organ like stomach, lung, heart, and kidney. When two or more organs perform a common function by their physical and or chemical interaction, they together form an organ system. Example, digestive system, respiratory system, etc. So, cells, tissues, organs and organ system split up the work in a way that exhibit division of labor and contribute to the survival of a body as a whole. Children, now let us discuss about the definition of tissue. Tissue means a group of cells working together to bring out a function is known as tissue. The advantages of tissue in a multicellular organism is division of labor. Let's discuss about animal tissue. Animal tissue mainly categorized into epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue, nerve tissue. Again, this epithelial tissue divides into squamous tissue, cuboidal tissue, columnar tissue, ciliated tissue, glandular tissue. Come to connective tissue. Connective tissue undergoes for areolar, adipose, skeletal, and fluid. Come to areolar, tendon and ligament. Divides into bone and cartilage. Come to fluid, blood and lymph. Children, now let us discuss in detail about these animal tissues. The structure of cells vary according to their function. Therefore, the tissues are different and are broadly classified into mainly four types, that is epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue, and neural tissue. Now let us discuss about first epithelial tissue. The word epithelium was introduced by Rusch. We commonly refer to an epithelial tissue as epithelium. This tissue has a free surface which faces either a body fluid or the outside of environment, and thus provides a covering or a lining for same part of the body. The cells are compactly packed with little intercellular matrix. There are two types of epithelial tissues, mainly simple epithelium tissue and compound epithelium tissue. The compound epithelium tissue consists of two or more cell layers and has protective function as it does in our skin. Now let us discuss about the classification of epithelial tissue. First, let us discuss about simple epithelium. Simple epithelium is a simple in structure and basically formed by single layer cells. Simple epithelium is composed of a single layer of cells and functions as a lining for body activity, ducts and tubes. On the basis of structural modification of the cells, simple epithelium is further divided into three types. There are squamous, cuboidal, columnar, ciliated epithelium. Let us discuss about simple squamous epithelium. The squamous epithelium is made up of a single thin layer of flattened cells with irregular boundaries. They are found in the walls of blood vessels and air sacs of lungs and are involved in functions like forming a diffusion boundary. Simple cuboidal. The simple cuboidal epithelium is composed of a single layer of cube-like cells. This is commonly found in ducts of glands and tubular parts of nephrons in kidney, and its main functions are secretion and absorption. The epithelium of proximal convoluted tubule of nephron in the kidney has microvilli. Simple columnar epithelium. The columnar epithelium is composed of a single layer of tall and slender cells. Their nuclei are located at the base. Free surface may have microvilli. They are found in the lining of stomach and intestine and help in secretion and absorption. Simple ciliated epithelium. If the columnar or cuboidal cells bear cilia on their free surface, they are called ciliated epithelium. Their function is to move particles or mucus in a specific direction over the epithelium. They are mainly present in the inner surface of hollow organs like bronchioles and fallopian tubes. Some of the columnar or cuboidal cells get specialized for secretion and are called glandular epithelium. They are mainly of two types. Unicellular consists of isolated glandular cells and multicellular consists of cluster of cells like salivary glands. On the basis of the mode of pouring of their secretion, glands are divided into two categories, mainly exocrine and endocrine glands. Exocrine glands secretes mucus, saliva, earwax, oil, milk, digestive enzymes and other cell products. These products are released through ducts or tubes. It contacts endocrine glands do not have ducts. Their products called hormones, they secrete directly into the fluid battening the gland. Now let us discuss about compound epithelium. This type of epithelium is made up of more than one layer of cells. It is protective in nature and present in skin, lining of buccal cavity, pancreatic ducts, etc. Compound epithelium is made up of more than one layer of cells and thus has a limited role in secretion and absorption. Their main function is to provide protection against chemical and mechanical stresses. They cover the dry surface of the skin, the moist surface of buccal cavity, pharynx, inner lining of ducts, of salivary glands and of pancreatic ducts. All cells in epithelium are held together with a little intercellular material. In nearly all animal tissue, specialized junctions provide both structural and functional links between its individual cells. Three types of cells junctions are found in the epithelium and other tissues. They are called as tight, adhering and gap functions. Tight functions help to stop substance from leaking across a tissue. Adhering junctions perform cementing to keep neighboring cells together. Gap junctions facilitate to the cell to communicate with each other by connecting the cytoplasm of adjoining cells for rapid transfer of ions, small molecules and sometimes big molecules. Now let us discuss about connective tissue. Connective tissue is mainly divided again into three types. One is connective tissues proper, and second one is skeletal tissues, third one is vascular tissue. Come to the connective tissues proper, again it's divided into areolar tissue, adipose tissue, white fibrous tissue, yellow elastic tissue, reticular tissues. Come to skeletal system, tissues are cartilage, bone, as we discussed. Again, this cartilage undergoes for hyaline, fibrous, classified, and fibrous for white and elastic. Come to the bone, compact bone and spongy bone. Vascular tissues are blood and lymph. Connective tissue was called mesenchyma by Hertwig in 1893. Connective tissues are most abundant and widely distributed in the body of complex animals. They are named connective tissues because of their special functions of linking and supporting other tissues, organs of the body. They arrange from soft connective tissues to specialized types, which include cartilage, bone, adipose, and blood. In all connective tissues except blood, the cells secrete fibers of structural proteins called collagen or elastin. The fibers provide strength, elasticity, and flexibility to the tissue. These cells are also secrete modified polysaccharides which accumulate between cells and fibers and act as matrix, means ground substance. Connective tissues are classified into three types: loose connective tissue, dense connective tissue, and specialized connective tissue. First, let us discuss about loose connective tissue. Loose connective tissue has cells and fibers loosely arranged in a semi-fluid ground substance. For example, areolar tissue present beneath the skin. Often it serves as a support framework for epithelium. It contains fibroblasts, macrophages, and mast cells. Adipose tissue is another type of loose connective tissue located mainly beneath the skin. The cells of this tissue are specialized to store fats. The excess of nutrients which are not used immediately and converted into fats and are stored in this tissue. Fibrous and fibroblasts are compactly packed in the dense connective tissue. Orientation of fibrous show a regular or irregular pattern, and cells are dense regular and dense irregular tissue. In the dense regular connective tissues, the collagen fibers are present in two rows, mainly parallel bundles of fibers. Tendons, which attach skeletal muscles to bones, and ligaments, which attach one bone to another, are the examples of this tissue. Dense irregular connective tissue has fibroblasts and many fibers, mostly collagen. They are oriented differently. This tissue is present in the skin. Now let us discuss about dense connective tissue. As the name suggested, the cells of the dense connective tissue are tightly bound. Matrix of dense connective tissue contain fibers that are made up of collagen. Example, tendons and ligaments. Tendons attach muscles to bones, whereas ligaments connect bone to bone. Specialized tissue, connective tissue. Cartilage, bone, and blades are the various types of specialized connective tissue. The intercellular material of cartilage is solid and permeable and resist compression. Cells of these tissues are enclosed in a small cavities within the matrix secreted by them. Most of the cartilages in invertebrate embryos are replaced by bones in adults. Cartilage. Cartilage is present in the tip of nose, outer ear joints, between adjacent bones of the vertebral column, limbs, and hands in adults. It is an elastic movement tissue. There are three types of cartilage found in humans, that is hyaline cartilage, elastic cartilage, and fibrocartilage. It is mean for providing flexibility to the different parts of the body. Bones. Bones have a hard and non-permeable ground substance rich in calcium salts and collagen fibers, which give bone its strength. It is the main tissue that provides structural framework to the body. Bones support and protect softer tissues and organs. The bone cells are present in the space called lacunae. Limb bones, such as the long bones of the legs, serve weight-bearing functions. They also interact with skeletal muscles attached to them to bring about movements. Blood. Blood is considered as connective tissue because it connects different body systems from transport of oxygen, nutrients, and for removal of waste. Cells found in the blood are also follows. Erythrocytes or red blood cells are enucleated cells that helps in transport of oxygen and carbon dioxide. It contains a pigment hemoglobin that helps in transport of oxygen and carbon dioxide. The central atom found in hemoglobin is Fe2+. Leukocytes or white blood cells are of two types, granulocytes and agranulocytes. Granulocytes contain granules in the cytoplasm. It includes neutrophils, eosinophils, and basophils. Agranulocytes includes monocytes, macrophages, and lymphocytes. The bone marrow in some bones is the site of production of blood cells. Blood is a fluid connective tissue containing plasma, red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets. It is the main circulating fluid that helps in transportation of various substances. You will learn about blood in chapter 17 and 18. Now let us discuss about muscle tissue. Muscle tissue is a soft tissue which compresses muscles in animal bodies. The cells of muscle tissues are called myocytes. Each muscle is made up of many long cylindrical fibers arranged in a parallel rise. These fibers are composed of numerous fine fibrils called myofibrils. Muscle fibrils contact in response to stimulation, then relaxation, and then returns to their uncontracted state in a coordinated fashion. This action moves the body to adjust to the changes in the environment and to maintain the positions of the various parts of the body. In general, muscles play an active role in all the movements of the body. Muscles are of three types: skeletal, smooth, and cardiac. Let us discuss about skeletal muscle tissue. Is closely attached to skeleton bones. In a typical muscle such as the biceps, serrated skeletal muscle fibers are bundled together in a parallel fashion. A sheet of tough connective tissue encloses the several bundles of muscle fibers, and you will learn about this in chapter 20. Smooth muscle fibers taper at both ends and do not show striations. Cell junctions hold them together, and their organs, such as the blood vessels, stomach, and intestine, contains this type of muscle tissue. Smooth muscles are involuntary as their functions cannot be directly controlled. We usually are not able to make it contact merely by thinking about it, as we can do with skeletal muscles. Cardiac muscle is a contactical tissue present only in the heart. Cell junctions fuse the plasma membranes of cardiac muscle cells and make them stick together. Communication junctions at the same fusion points allow the cells to contract as a unit. That is, when one cell receives a signal to contact, its neighbors are also stimulated to contact. Now let us discuss about nerve tissue. Nerve tissues are again are divided into neurons, neuroglial cells, ependymal cells, neurosecretory cells. Again, these neurons divided into cell body, nerve fibers. Again, the cell body undergoes for unipolar, bipolar and multipolar. Comes to nerve fibers, it divided into medullated and non-medullated. Nerve tissues exert the greatest control over the body responsiveness to changing conditions. Neurons, the unit of neural system, are excitable cells. The neurological cells, which constitute the rest of the neural system, protect and support neurons. Neuroglia make up more than one half the volume of neural tissue our body. When a neuron is suitably stimulated, an electric disturbance is generated, which swiftly travels along its plasma membrane. Arrival of the disturbance at the neuron's ending or out zone triggers events that may cause stimulations or inhibition of adjust your neurons and other cells. You will study the details in chapter 21. Thank you.